Respected Sapnadeep Saab, his team from NMDC spread over Panna, Donimalai, Bailadila and Hyderabad and other places, and our other invitees. We will be listening to Mr. Satpathy, who brings with him lot of experience, right from Malanskan to Bailadila to head office at the in the board of NMDC. He will tell us about sustainable development in iron ore mining. Actually, sustainable development has come with MMDR and all those regulatory framework, but NMDC followed it since 1960s, because my association with NMDC was ex-NMDC Kiriburu. There we have seen how systematically NMDC implemented sustainable development in technology and CSR when there were no laws on CSR and sustainable development. And now when you travel from Jagdalpur to Bailadila, you will find NMDC is not missing anywhere. At the outskirts of Bailadila, you will find a beautiful medical college on the left side when you travel from Bailadila, Jagdalpur to Bailadila. And further ahead, you will find the education city in the heart of tribal land where nationalism is at peak. In spite of all the odds, with a lot of jungles all around and also forest, no man's land and whatnot, with all the odds, NMDC could build an education hub. And from there, when you come down, you will find Bailadila, the best iron ore mines India has ever produced. With these words, I request Mr. Mittal, our director training, to welcome the guests, and thereafter we'll start the proceedings. Mr. Satpathy will speak to us with his lot of experience. Mr. Mittal, please.
Sir, good evening, sir. I welcome you to the webinar. Myself, A.K. Mittal, retired as a general manager for Coal India Limited. Last year, I was worked at a general manager at SCCL in Sohagpur area. Then for the next 2 years, I was there as a vice president in Hindalco. And since 2015, I am with Dr. G.K. Pradhan at AKS University as a director training. It is a great privilege that you have joined us and you have given a valuable time. Many mining engineers, many fraternities and our students are eager to listen to you.
So Professor Jayantu is also.
Professor Jayantu has also joined. So I also welcome Mr. Professor Jayantu. And now just stopping my words, I will request you to start your speech, sir.
Over to Satpathy Saab.
Yeah, thank you and good afternoon to all. First of all, I congratulate AKS University Satna, where our old friend Mr. G.K. Pradhan is at the helm of the affairs. And because of his initiative, his networking, he has been able to conduct various webinars during this pandemic period. I am aware that recently the SAIL executive director and then Coal India's chairman, all those, they have delivered through the webinar organized through AKS University. And since his attachment is there with IME journal, so he is also taking along with in all his efforts the IMENJ journal also, and it is a good thing, and it's a good initiative taken by the university as a whole. And during this pandemic period where we cannot physically go and attend various places, the technology has come to our doorstep through which we are able to interact with each other in such webinars. And today's webinar subject has been given by Pradhan Saab as sustainable iron ore mining. So when we say sustainable iron ore mining, and already he has told during his introductory speech about Bailadila, which was the stepping stone in iron ore mining for NMDC to start the activities, mining activities during 60s. And I'll try to share this screen have a small presentation, and through the presentation, I'll show you through the various informations regarding NMDC, then pillars of sustainability, and also I'll talk something about rating, which is a initiative taken by government of India, Ministry of Mines through IBM. Just a minute, let me try share the screen. Are you able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
So this is sustainable iron mining from NMDC. I am presenting this. We have a tagline that is expanding horizons and spreading smiles. Actually, this is a tagline attached to NMDC, and also during our endeavor to published the sustainability report that was in 2018, and then in 2019 also we published our sustainability report. There also we had this same title. So what I am going to cover about NMDC in short, then I am going to talk something about pillar of sustainability, three pillars mainly, and then five star rating, which was introduced by Ministry of Mines, Government of India through Indian Bureau of Mines. Then the approach of NMDC, sustainability, exploration, R&D, and through scientific mining. Then I will talk about something, then waste management is also one of the important
factors.
I think there is some disturbance. Please stop side talks. Otherwise, you will not be able to listen. Yeah, then waste management and mine closure obligation, then carbon footprint studies, that is greenhouse gas reduction, that also NMDC has taken a stride in that direction, and safety, which is also an integral part of sustainability, that also whatever initiatives has been taken, that I'll like to say something about it. And then NMDC CSR is a CSR which is now assuming one of the most important thing for any company, for that matter, for any mining company to sustain or to survive or to have the hold among the stakeholders. The CSR initiatives and the implementations are very important. Then we have taken that, I was just talking about this sustainability report, that through global reporting initiatives, and through that we have, this is a voluntary actually decision to go for this GRI initiative, and through that we have tried to find out the gap between what actually is required to get good score and what is existing. Then some of the awards and recognition that NMDC has got, that I will try to say. So what we do, NMDC, as in NMDC, you know, we are basically iron ore miners, and from exploration to sale, the exploration, production, then processing, loading, dispatch, all these are the activities we do. And during these activities, we also contribute to the society. And I find actually I am proud to share with all of you that although we have a diamond mine in Madhya Pradesh for which also the lease renewal is due, already one part is over, only the wildlife clearance is to be obtained, and we have been allocated two coal mines in Jharkhand, that is through government dispensation route, and we are trying to start it within the timelines given to us, and we have got a limestone mine and also a silica sand mine in UP, and there we have got one gold mine through auction, that is in Andhra Pradesh, but that is at present sub judice, so the expression of interest would not be issued by the state government. That is for this. Then the historical milestones of NMDC during the last 60 years of excellence, So it was incorporated in 1958, and then through the years, how the journey has been, regarding commissioning of the first mine, then listed on Indian Stock Exchange in 97, then Navaratna status we got in 2008, then forward integration, that is decision to start a steel plant, integrated steel plant in Jagdalpur, that was taken in 2009. Then 2017, we surpassed the zinc, that is 34 million tons of production and sale of 35 million tons, 17-18. And in 2019-20, actually, when all the leases in Chhattisgarh were due for renewal, that was also a very period of tension. And through efforts of our management, and particularly our CMD, who is actually retiring today, who is ex-Chhattisgarh cadre IS officer, so we got all the renewals. This is a pioneer in Indian mining industry. Why we say ourselves as a pioneer? Because, see, we can see the rich heritage. We have got more than 6 decades of experience in exploration and mining, and majority of ownership owned by Government of India for over last 6 decades, and it is now classified as Navratna. And we have got a very large iron ore resource base, which is more than 3 billion tons of hematite ore as per UNFC standards. And then the mines are having proximity to the key demand centers, actually close to the end-use industries. And we have access to very reserves of very high-grade iron ore. You will be those who do not know about Varadila. So we have got average grade of 64% Fe. And in deposit 5, I'll come in the latter side, in latter slides. So that deposit 5 has a lump of, the base grade is 67%, and we get almost sometimes up to 69.5% of Fe content. And the strategic plan to drive growth, we have already prepared one strategic plan to reach 67 million ton per annum by 2025. And we have strengthened our exploration, and also for forward integration of our business, we have gone for this pellet plant in Donimalai, and similar pellet plant is we have already earmarked in Jagdalpur, that is near to our Nagarnar steel plant. One pellet plant will be there, and steel plant is already under construction, and it is nearing completion. This year it will be completed, the Nagarnar steel plant. And we have our global presence. We have invested in companies like Legacy Iron Ore Limited in Perth, in Australia, and through consortium, and through other PPSUs like SAIL and RNLR partners, NMDC is also a stakeholder in that. So we have a coal mine, that is a coking coal mine in Mozambique. At present, we have got very good, strong financials. The market cap is of the order of 26,423.76 crores. And during FY20, the revenue was 11,699 crore, and operating EBITDA was around 55%. So for sustainable iron mining, these are the things which actually help us in saying that we have sustainable iron mining, because the strong in-house capability in mineral exploration estimation, and we have a very good R&D center here in Hyderabad. We are the single largest iron ore producer in the country. If you take the total iron ore production, then we stand at 18-19% of the total production. And if you take only the merchant mining, then it is more than 20%. And we are also the low-cost producer of iron ore in India. Financial performance, I have already said, and we have got very strong domestic and international customer base. Continuous thrust on environment, health, and safety. That I will address during the subsequent slides. Corporate social responsibility initiatives also, whatever has been taken by NMDC, those are all unique initiatives. And as Dr. Pradhan was saying, in that area which does not have the basic amenities, that the presence of NMDC only has helped the area develop like anything. And world-class infrastructures, with regard to the education are already established in Gidam, which is close next to Dantewada, which is highly infested with Naxals. And also in Bijapur district also, we are similar this education center is coming up. And the corporate governance, we have a very good corporate governance, and we have a number of awards and accolades got during the last so many years. This is the geographical presence in India. You can see from the north almost to south, the presence is there. Of course, Panthal magnesite plant is at present it is suspended because of the clearance. We could not get clearance from Shrine Board. This Panthal limestone project, this is in Arki near to Simla. Then Lalapur silica sand project, that is in UP near to Allahabad. Then Panna diamond mine, almost at the center of the country, that is near Panna. We have got a mechanized iron mine, Panna diamond mine. And this Rohini and Tokishut coal block, you can see these are the two blocks in Jharkhand we have got recently. The work is yet to start because a lot of formalities are to be over. And here this integrated steel plant in Nagarnar is a green line. All the green lines shows the upcoming projects not yet commissioned. And then you can see the main projects of NMDC are in Chhattisgarh, that too in Bastar area. One is Bacheli complex, which we call Deposit 5, and it has three Deposit 5, 10 and Deposit 11A, and Kirandul complex, which comprises of Deposit 14, Deposit 11C and Deposit 11. So this is about Chhattisgarh. We have got one sponge iron unit in Palwancha, and also we have got the Donimalai complex, that is in Karnataka, in the Bellary district. We have got two mines there, Donimalai and Kumaraswamy mine. Donimalai mine at present is work is suspended because of some issues with this state government. Kumaraswamy mine is operating, and we have got a pellet plant in the Donimalai complex, 1.2 million ton per annum capacity. And we have also taken land for steel SPV, that is not yet started, only land acquisition has been made and other things are being taken up. This Chigargunta Vishwanathan gold block, I was mentioning in the initial part of my presentation, that we have got, that was earlier with BGML, but now we have taken under auction, but since it is sub judice, there is some court case going on, so we could not get the expression of interest and all of the formalities that is to be done. This is the Google map of the various deposits under Kirandul projects. You can see this deposit 14, that is the first mine which was started in Bellary region by NMDC. Then we have got deposit 11, we have got deposit 5, and then deposit 13 also under NCL, that is NMDC, CMDC Limited. Deposit 13 we have got, but due to some issues, the work could not be started till now. And deposit 10 is there in the Bacheli complex, and deposit 5. Deposit 4, the deposit has been, this block has been allocated to NCL through government dispensation route. So this is all about here. Yeah, we have got all these operating mines as shown in the slide. This is the some means timeline, you can say commissioning, when it is commissioned, then total lease area of Kirandul iron ore mine, then EC capacity is 19 million ton, screening capacity at present is 14 million ton, and a total resource in Kirandul, or that is around 1398 million tons. And 1977 Bacheli got started, whereas Kirandul got started in 1968. Total lease area for Bacheli is 956 hectares, and EC capacity is 18.8 million tons. It includes both deposit 5 and deposit 10-11A. And the screening capacity at present is 15 million ton. It is being upgraded, and the total resource is shown there. Then the Donimalai Iron Complex, I was mentioning at present the operation is suspended due to non-renewal of lease because of some conditions, premium conditions which was imposed in the lease which NMDC did not agree. It is sub judice. So Kumaraswamy mine is under operation. It is having capacity, EC capacity of 7 million ton. And for this mine, we have already got this IBM approval for increasing to 10 million ton. The FC is yet to be obtained. After that, this mine can operate at 10 million ton capacity. This is our Donimalai, when it was commissioned 1977, then total lease area 1245. EC capacity is 14. This includes both Kumaraswamy and Donimalai mine, and screen capacity is also 14 million. We have got this global footprint. We have got presence in other countries like Mozambique, Tanzania, and Australia. Mozambique, we have got 26% stake in ICBL, which owns this coking coal deposit in Mozambique. And this was acquired from Rio Tinto, actually. And ICBL has 65% ownership in Benga coal project and 100% interest in Zambezi. There are these different leases are there, different properties are there. So how much percentage this ICBL owns, it is shown here. At present, we are producing around 1.78 million ton of coking and thermal coal. And we have got a gold mining lease in Tanzania. So actually, we have got four leases in Tanzania. This is Buliang Ombe, the name is called, and it is in Novo. And, actually, here this exploration work is going on, and we recently received the draft exploration report. We are going through it. Australia, we have got 92.32% stake in the Legacy Iron Ore Limited. It is a stock exchange listed entity based in Perth, Australia. Legacy is presently carrying out exploration in 21 exploration tenements, and iron ore already we have got around 2 billion tons. Gold, tungsten, and other base metals are being looked after through exploration. And it is expected because the recent findings through exploration is indicating that maybe we are going to strike a very good gold deposit, and gold mine in pre-production stage is planned in FY20. And in 21, the drilling target also simultaneously, we are doing a lot of exploration work there. And we've already completed 3,000 meters, further 7,000 meters has been planned to drill through exploration. This is this domestic and international customer base. In domestic, you can see all the major steel producers like SR, now it is Arsenal Mittal. And we have got JSW Ispat as the major customer in Karnataka. JSW Ispat from Chhattisgarh, they are sourcing. JSW Steel is in Karnataka. They are sourcing from our this Karnataka mines, that is Kumaraswamy mines at present. And KIC is also sourcing from us, from mainly from Bairarila. And CG units, the sponge iron units, they are sourcing from our Bairarila mines. And Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited, located at Visakhapatnam, they are also one of the major customers who are sourcing their both lumps and fines requirement from Bairarila mines. So you can see, I've already said about this, the quality of ore. And we have started this looking at the requirements of the customers. Earlier, we were having three products. Now we have added one more product to that, the 10-20 millimeter size, because most of the private miners, they are having this product size, which is also having a lot of demand. So we have started these also. And for exports, we are exporting to mainly Japan, and some quantity of fines to South Korea. So it is hardly 2 to 2.5 to 3 million ton in all for both lump and fines. And with increase in our production and dispatch, the share of export is also going to increase, maybe increased up to 5 million ton in the future. I was talking about the sustainability. So what do we mean by sustainability? Sustainability the development meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of the future generations to meet their own needs. This is Brundtland report, the World Commission on Environment and Development, 1980. This was the statement about sustainable development. That means present generation ka need, you may meet the requirement of present generation, and at the same time don't compromise with the future requirement, future generations requirement. That is actually the, in short, the sustainable development what we mean. If we want to explain in terms of technically, then the next is value creation for the stakeholders over material issues leading to future proofing, and which actually means in that mining that is financially viable. It has to be there, otherwise nobody would like to do any business unless and until it is financially viable. It should be socially responsible, because the responsibility in terms of so many things like pollution and the development, social responsible work like CSR, all those things come under this. And then environmentally also it has to be good. Otherwise, if there is a pollution through water pollution or air pollution, lot of resentment will be there, lot of complaints will be there, a lot of violations will be there, which will make the business unviable, because there will be imposition of a penalty. There may be authorities may ask the industry to close down. So these are the subsequential effects should are not sound in environmental management. And technically it is required, because you have to move along with the technical advancement, and the technical advancements in terms of it actually encompasses even the pollution, like noise pollution, the energy efficiency, and all those things come under the technical advancement. And scientifically sound, scientifically whatever you do, that must be as per some logical way you must carry out your work, like how you deal with your waste, how the mine is planned, how the grid is controlled, how the benches move, and how the shape of the benches, like height, width, all those things are maintained, the slope of ramp, all those things constitute the scientific way of working. And with a long-term view of development, it uses mineral resources optimally, that is mineral conservation is addressed here, and ensures sustainable post-closure land uses. That is very important, because after mining, usually the miners leave the area as it is, but here I must say that IBM long back, they have taken a step that this mine closure plan has to be in place. Before the mine is started, your mine closure plan has to be in place, and it will be planned in advance, and it has to be taken approval of. So these are the requirements. Here it has been shown, all the three circles, the social, economic, and environment, the intersection of all these, the area, you can see the common area of intersection. That is actually, if you are able to comply with the social, economic, and then sustainability, you'll be able to achieve. This is the, usually, you've seen these are the sustainable elements in the mining industry. Some of them already addressed in my last slide. But it's more elaborated in a more way. In scientific mining technology, I was talking about the technology, mine transport and haulage optimization, because mine haulage constitutes the maximum expenditure in terms of money, also in terms of uses of the fuels and all those things. So that has to be optimized. Fugitive emission control, that is a very health hazards will be there, and lot of resentment will be there if there is fugitive emission in and around the mine. Then lean ore beneficiation, that comes under this mineral conservation. So when you are mining, you should not leave out the lean ore, how to beneficiate it and make best use of the ore after beneficiation. That also should constitute in the sustainability. And tailing management, those who are aware about this iron ore mining, you know that the ore is vast, and after that the silica mainly is removed by washing, and there is a tailing pond. It moves to the tailing pond, so the grade is improved after the screening and wet screening and the tailing management. However, now a lot of improvement has come in this area, like this pest control, pest thickener technology, which requires less space, whereas in tailing dam earlier, which was a plant, lot of space is required, and also lot of issues are there. So lot of improvements have taken place in the tailing management technology. Then land and waste management, this is also very important, because most of the mines are situated in the forest area, and also you have got a definite lease under your control. So how the waste is to be managed, so that there is no it should not flow away during rainy season, or it should not slide down beyond the area. All these things have to be seen, how the waste dump is to be planned, how the stability of the waste dump is to be there, how it can be made stable. All those things I'll show in the there are some pictures of actual implementation that also, but these constitute one of the most important also factor nowadays. And nowadays even MOEF also, while giving the clearance, MOEF permission, they are also asking how much waste. Earlier it was not there, now we have to give in our statement how much waste we are going to handle, and that permission, that quantity also permission they are going to, they are giving, and how it is to be done, the land and waste management, that is also to be one of the chapter in the forest clearance application. Water conservation is very important, because water is as a resource, is a scarce resource, and you go on consuming it and without conserving, then there may be shortage of water. Water is required for drinking, water is required industrially, so very judiciously it has to be done, and for that water conservation measures as a sustainable practice needs to be made. Biodiversity, it is also very important in the forest areas. There's a lot of rare species of flora and fauna are there, how they are to be conserved, and all the what measures should be taken. Nowadays we have to give a biodiversity report also, how it is to be conserved, all those things, how much we are going to spend towards the biodiversity measures, that also needs to be given. Energy saving and GHG management, this is also very important, because you know for each unit of energy, again you spend a lot of this thing, natural resource. So if you can cut down on energy saving by using better energy efficient equipments, then you are indirectly saving on the minerals or fuels for that matter. GHG management, greenhouse gas, this is also very important from environmental point of view. And renewable energy, it is also nowadays the government is also giving thrust for this renewable energy. And not renewable energy, this windmills, solar, all these things come. Then sustainability, innovation and R&D projects. Then supply chain and sustainable sourcing. Mine life extension, mine closure, reclamation, every sort. Compliance is very important, because nowadays a lot of rules, regulations, acts, they are getting amended. Things are going from tough to tougher. Then labor standards, a lot of labor amendments, law amendments also going on now. And the standards also have to be met in terms of safety and other amenities. Code of conduct is there. Human rights also nowadays, lot of NGOs are now working in and around the mining areas, and any issue it is escalated through this NGO. So this also has to be taken care of. Health and safety, not only for workers, it also applies to all the nearby surrounding villagers. Any health and safety issue because of the mining, that has to be given utmost priority for sustainability point of view. Training is required. Training also It is not only for employees. For employees, it is required for increasing or improving the skill set. Other than that, they have to be made aware about the environmental things, safety. Likewise, the surrounding villagers also are covered through training as a sustainability measure. I'm sorry. This corporate governance also needs to be in place for effecting all these, what I have told. Vigilance and anti-corruption. You are doing all good things, but if there is some corrupt practice or some vigilance cases against people, any unethical things are going on in your organization, that is also not good from a sustainability point of view. It is going to affect the corporation or the business as a whole. Customer satisfaction and value creation, this is very important, because customers, they are the kings, they are the gods. If they are satisfied and if you are able to create a value in your value chain, then it is going to be sustainable. The stakeholder dialogues, that is what I am talking about, the all the stakeholders, including the in and the surrounding villagers, the suppliers, vendors, and employees, all they constitute the stakeholders. We have to have dialogue with them, understand their issues, and we have to address those issues through the mechanisms. CSR is one thing I have already told about the importance. All of us understand the importance of CSR. And a place where the development is not at all there, where the it's a very remote place is there, where government is not able to do much, there the importance of CSR is a multifold. And I am proudly sharing with all of you that in respect of CSR expenditure and the activities that has been undertaken through NMDC projects, that is really appreciable, and you will see the glimpses of it through some of the slides I am going to show in the subsequent slides. The grievance redress, all this grievance may be from the employees, that is internal, and also grievance can be from external. That mechanism should be there, and it should be transparent, and then only this will help in your sustainability of your organization. And the marketing communication, this is very important. Of course, it is assuming more and more importance nowadays. Earlier, it was not that much important for a company like NMDC, but nowadays, the competition is increasing. The number of minds coming in the competition are increasing. And also, the communication removes so many unnecessary doubts among the customers. There are so many examples. If you are able to have a good communication system with your customers or for your marketing purpose, that solves so many issues. I'm talking about this step taken by Government of India through Indian Bureau of Mines. They have introduced a star rating system, which is really as a implementation of sustainable development framework, SDF. Under this system, the star rating would be awarded on self-certification basis. Then it will be filed by the lessee, then it will be validated by IBM, and final rating will be awarded accordingly. This system, rating assessment system, has helped many of the mines to improve their system, improve their you can say record keeping, their compliance status. All those things have improved so as to enable them to get the star rating as required by IBM. So every holder of mining lease or monitoring mining and allied activities as per the notified template, already there is a circular by IBM where it wherein it says about what are the requirements of all those things. I think all those who are involved in mining activities, they must be aware, otherwise they can see the IBM circular to know about the more about the five-star rating. Under this SDF five-star rating, the seven mainly parameters, these parameters are assessed. The management of impact by carrying out scientific and epistemic, that is assessed. whether you are doing scientific mining or not. Then social impact, that is rehabilitation requirements for taking up mining, whether it has been done or not, local community engagements and welfare, that is CSR activities and other engagement activities, whether company is doing or not. The sufficient evidence of all these things will be verified by the authorities and accordingly will be assessed. Then steps taken for progressive and final mining closure plan, what company has taken steps for all these things, adoption of international standards, then royalty and other contributions, whether it is being done properly or not, timely or not, statutory compliances, lease area outlays, all these things are assessed for this five-star rating. And this is the table I can show you, that except some of the we are almost we are five-star rating, and only this deposit 11 is three-star and others four-star. So this is the exploration activities. I was saying the exploration is also required, because you cannot, you have got a limited reserve unless you explore for your own company and also for the country. You should be engaged in the exploration activities. And NMDC has been from the very beginning known as an exploration company, and we have been conducting G4 to G1 level of exploration of various minerals. And during this NMDR Act amendment also, NMDC was empaneled as a nodal agency for exploration under subsection 1 of section 4 of NMDR. Earlier only GSI and MECL had this authorization, but now a lot of agencies around, I think 17 or 18 PSUs including GSI, they are all authorized to carry out exploration in the blocks. There is a NMET block, NMET, National Mineral Exploration Trust. Actually, there is a trust who decide about the various blocks to be explored from G4 to G1. And NMDC is at present doing in five areas which has been allocated to NMDC. As a MOU, Memorandum of Understanding with the state of MP, NMDC is doing this exploration was in 24 blocks. I think Mr. Pradhan, Dr. Pradhan may be aware of it, in and around Panna area and also near to Singroli and Jabalpur. We are covering almost more than 7,000 square kilometer area for various minerals, where it has been discovered. One iron ore deposit we have discovered near to Jabalpur, which is having 63% Fe, around 30 million ton reserve. MPC we have found out input reserves, and one manganese ore deposit around 28% manganese with 25 million ton, that is also input resource, and around 45 diamond target areas we are now doing under exploration, and we are sure that we will come out with some results this year itself. NMDC has a well-established exploration division. We have got remote sensing, we have got aerogeographical, geophysical data analysis, and ground geophysics and geochemistry. And we have got drilling, we have got almost 10 rigs for carrying out this exploratory drilling. Now at present we are doing in-house exploration in actually in our lease areas. And last year we had done around more than 17,000 meters during the year. We have got the capability of doing ore body modeling and geostatistical tools also for exploration. Our exploration division is also engaged in applying additional areas for adding new areas under the Jharkhand, Odisha, AP, Telangana, Chhattisgarh. In Global Exploration Center, I have said the 10 drill rigs are there, and we are doing in-house drilling. We have developed one Bhuvan app for capturing the data from the field itself. The Bhuvan NMDC app has been created. So from field, suppose somebody is doing exploration in Jabalpur or near Singrauli area, he can feed there in his mobile app, and it can be read here sitting in Hyderabad or anywhere. Yeah, this is our R&D. We have got a very good R&D center, which is also declared as a center of excellence in UNIDO. These are the facilities we have got. I'm not going into detail, but we have got all the facilities like hydrometallurgy, then bulk solid flow, low flowability, and we have also collaborations with reputed institutes like CSIRO, Australia, IIT Bhubaneswar, CSIR IMMT Bhubaneswar, NIT Raipur, CSIR CIMPR for multiple objective studies for improving upon the conditions. Already 18 patents have been filed by the department, including 6 in 2020. The investment is 33.4 crores in 2020 for R&D, and we are increasing the portion of expenditure year by year. It is certified with the ISO system, and also we have enabled accreditation not only for R&D center, for all the chemical labs in the projects we have put enabled. This is the major initiatives taken towards sustainable mining by our this thing. We are using mine planning software, so very judiciously planned where the mine is being worked out, and exploration, I have said, we have got very systematic exploration activity, and the roads, ramps within the active mines are designed in such a way so that the optimization, pit optimization study is achieved, done, and the roads are made such that it serves for a longer time, and also it helps us in excavating the ore efficiently and effectively. Blending of low-grade ore with high-grade ore, that we are doing almost 16 to 20% low-grade ore we blend. Rest for rest low-grade which cannot be blended, we have a separate stockpile, and as and when required we blend it with the high-grade. In-pit sump for rainwater harvesting is we have started in all our mines, and large diameter rotary drills and high capacity HM equipments are being used. We have in all the mines we are now using this bulk explosive systems, highly mechanized iron ore crushing, screening and loading plants, processing of ore through dry circuit, which helps in mineral conservation and avoids contamination of natural water sources surrounding area. It also helps in usage of less water. This is one technology. We are also this one collaboration with CSIRO. We are trying to develop the process, the dry processing of ore, dry beneficiation. This construction of buttress walls, garland, and these are all required for this environmental protection purpose, and plantation of local grass species over broken land to prevent soil erosion during monsoon, because very highly prone to heavy rain there in Varadila, as you all know. So we have to take a lot of measures so as to conserve or preserve the land, which should not be otherwise flown away because of the heavy rain. Then this lead distance of dumper and all these things are done to optimize the lead distance so as to control over the cost of production, and also the use of diesel per ton, diesel consumption also. So these are some of the pictorial, you can see this is a single flight downhill conveyor towards the extreme right of the top. Downhill conveyor, there is no this transfer suits or transfer points are not there. The single bed horizontal and vertical curves are, this is very unique and also very useful. This is gyratory primary crusher, where you can see the water sprinkling arrangements working here for controlling the dust, vegetative dust. So we have got heavy, high capacity 100 ton dumper in all the mines. We have got high capacity hydraulic shovels. This is a downhill conveyor system, which is all protected by the seats and all that. Then this is automatic fire detection and suppression system in tunnel conveyors, or in the eventuality of any fire, this automatic system has been installed to prevent any fire from spreading. It will address there and then. Then the screening plant, you can see very pictures scene is there. This is also the one of the biggest screening plant of this Pirandul. Then this dosing of water polymer on wet iron ore. This is one thing we started through our R&D initiative, and that is we have been dosing up for this water absorbing polymer to reduce the moisture content, so that the jamming and all the things should not happen in the suits. That is for process improvement, efficiency improvement. Ripple screen also we have introduced for improving the screening efficiency. And this is Canon. This is the system for the dust suppression, and this check dam you can see next. These are some of the scenes. This is a windmill in Chitradurga in Karnataka. NMDC has got around 10.5 megawatt capacity of this windmill operating there in Chitradurga district. These are all the areas which have been earlier these were all waste dumps. Now they have been established, and you can see plantation and the stepping also has been done to improve the stability of these. So these are the gabion walls as in the forest areas, and you can see all these things have been done. This is the sprinkling going on. Figures, the 22% we are getting, 22% of our consumption we are getting as a renewable energy, and we are saving around 975 megawatt per hour because of the efforts, energy efficiency methods. This is 25 lakhs this plantation have been carried out so far, and area covered by geotextile for this stabilization of dumping area. So we have covered so far 53,150 square meter area, and more are in the process. 27 check dams have been constructed. These are all the figures showing what has been done. These are all common things. So I am not going into detail of these things while drilling, blasting, extraction, transportation, how the dust is taken care of or controlled, all those things, crushing downhill, all the everywhere we have got system. It's also accompanied by the photographs to realize how it is being done. We have got ambience air quality monitoring stations all in all the projects. That is nowadays mandatory also, and it is being done. This automatic weather station we have installed, and this is a QMS display how it is being done in the projects. The noise pollution also I am not going to detail because these are all routine things we do, and this is a continuous process. I am not going. ये तो हो गया, इसके बाद ये आना चाहिए ना, ये सब नहीं आ रहा है। शक्ति आना चाहिए, शक्ति एनर्जी मैनेजमेंट नहीं आया, कार्बन फुटप्रिंट स्टेशन वाटर पोल्यूशन के बाद नहीं आगे बढ़ रहा ट्रेलिंग मैनेजमेंट या इसके पहले जा चुकी है हाँ दिस वाटर पोल्यूशन मैनेजमेंट यू कैन सी द पिक्चरियल द एक्चुअल पिक्चर्स टेकन हाउ अबव दिस देयर इज अ ट्रेलिंग डैम इज देयर हाउ द वाटर इज clear water is coming. So all the things, this is a flotation pond. So water samples are being collected regularly, analyzed. These are all requirements also nowadays, and we are doing it very regularly to get idea about what is the disposed water, what the quality of the air, so that necessary action can be taken. The slime tailing management beneficiation system already there, classifier, hydrocyclone thickness are in place for recovery fine ore. These are utilization of tailings. So nowadays, actually, in Denumalai, we have established one pellet plant where the plant has been designed to utilize the tailings as input. So tailings actually are very micro fines, constitute very micro fines. So how to do that and what process, what technology has to be, all those have been done in Donimalai, and we have got 1.2 million ton per annum pellet plant there in Donimalai. The waste dump management, you can see how the waste dump management is done, retaining wall and the wrapped chain link mesh boulders wrapped in this. All these are people have developed all these new things and which are helping us to get the objective. The stabilization, you can see how the stepping has been done, terracing has been done, and then how it is, the means vegetation is done by planting agave or other soil binding species. Somewhere we are using the geocoir textile also. So all these things are done to improve the stability of the waste dumps mainly. And also here in your dynamic stockpile in deposit 5, we have done it. Mine closure obligation, NMDC has, apart from whatever bank guarantee you are required to give as per law, IBM has already spelled out all those things, but in addition to that, from 2009-10, we have a unique scheme in NMDC. We are sitting, as I said earlier, we are sitting only 10 rupees per ton. Now we have increased from last 2-3 years to 16.40 per ton of ore excavation. We are keeping it aside. The fund is kept aside for dealing with the situation where the mine closure actually will take place. So to have that fund in place, we have got this unique scheme, and it is a really good scheme. So far, 800 crores have been accumulated in the fund in the LIC. These are the, see, you can see operated areas after this plantation, how the areas are looking. Carbon footprint studies, this also we have started from 11-12 onwards. And through this GHG emission, we are monitoring how much GHG emission is being done and what measures are to be taken, and then next year, year-wise, we are taking. So how the GHG emission is reducing or what measures should be done to reduce, all those things we have checked out, and we are monitoring all these things. I told in the beginning about the energy management. The energy also is very important. If you do more work with less energy, or you have a better energy efficiency in your system, we are also having a sustainable practice in place. So it is a continuous journey, and we have some digital technologies and renewable energy, alternative fuel, energy audit we are carrying out in all the production projects. And whatever recommendations are there, we are implementing all those things. These are some of the recommendations, like eddy current control motors replaced with energy efficient motors with variable frequency drives in the OCSL plant. LT motor replaced with energy. All those things are outcome of the energy audit, and we are doing it. The safety, which is very important in the mining industry, in all industry it is important, in all spheres of life it is important. But the mining industry, we have to deal with safety with more focus. And you can see the number of accidents in total NMDC, which was almost more than 90, now has come down to 12, 13. And this includes all type of accident, including metal, chariots, reportable and non-reportable. You can see these are the statistical figures, which show that lot of decline in the accidents, a lot of improvements in the safety aspects have taken place. We have also for training the people, shovel simulators, dumper simulators in place in Kirandul and Donimalai and Bachuli. So we give the operators training through these simulators before actually putting them in the field on the actual equipment. So, and we have an internal safety audit. So this system we have started last 4-5 years before. In this, what we do, we composite team is formed from one project, and they go to other project to have the audit with all the safety checks list, and accordingly they come out with what are the shortcomings or which can lead to violations, and accordingly we take corrective measures so that during actual inspection by the statutory authorities, we do not have much of violations or do not have much of unsafe things in our system. Corporate level tripartite safety committee meeting, this is done by Director General of Mine Safety. So that is done regularly. And we have got all these safety awards, that Rintec Safety Award, then this, all this we have got. Corporate social responsibility, you can see we are spending almost 180 to 200 crores every year. And it is almost more than the statutory requirement, 2% of last 3 years PBT average. But we are doing more than that. It's almost 2.5 to 3% of the average of PBT of last 3 years. Also recently, for this pandemic, NMDC has contributed 150 crores to PM CARES Fund. All key areas of human development focused, such as education, healthcare, skill development, infrastructure, rural development, all these things are addressed through our CSR activities. Because this is not a CSR presentation, so I am just showing the pictures. Prime Minister has visited that education hub, what Dr. Pradhan was mentioning about. This is our hospital and wheelchair, wheels initiative, and the residential schools. All these things have been done by NMDC. And also through CSR, we are supporting 18,000 students approximately by providing them scholarship. Midday meal we are providing in 38 schools. Every year, we are almost having 1 lakh outpatients and around 10,000 inpatients from the local Adivasis. We treat them free, that is the thing. And 40,000 mobile medical units are there by us. Outside our area in the nearby villages, we have constructed around 89 culverts and bridges. These are all the figures which show the quantity of work that is. Some of the pictures, I think Dr. Pradhan was mentioning about the medical college. This last, you can see this last one, that medical college you can see, and all other things are showing the CSR activities. So, the other steps, plastic banning, then plantation. So for greenery development, we have already contributed 73 crores. And 190 crores per year average, we are spending towards CSR initiatives. I must share with you that NMDC has bagged S&P Global Metal Award, which is actually an international award. And subsequently in 2 years, 18 and 19, we have got it. And this is a very prestigious award. This is the chart, you can say how much percentage for what. You see, maximum we are CSR spend is towards education. Then next is infrastructure. Infrastructure includes the school buildings, roads, and all those things. then hygiene 12%, then environment 6%, and other 16%. This is the breakup. This global reporting initiative, I was telling, GRI initiative, that is sustainability report we have prepared out of this GRI initiative. That is a voluntary thing which we have done for ourselves. And this is mainly done to see the where we are now as per the assessment parameters and what are the gaps and how to go ahead in improving in, the, in those gap areas. So I'm not going detail into it. You can go through it in the presentation. And these are the parameters, indicators, sustainability indicators. This is financial, this is again financial, this is production, this is R&D, then star rating, environmental expenditures, plantation, then safety and CSR, and training. All these things you can see. As for this GRI initiatives, these are also monitored. These are also sustainability indicators for the mining companies, like diesel consumption, lubricant, electricity consumption, and this powder factor, that is for explosives. So this also you can see, not going detailed. The gap analysis is done, and we look at the areas, we make a work action plan, and then try to improve. Next audit by the this GRI initiatives, this audit will be taken up for sustainability assessment. That time we should have a improved figure. These are the procedure and things under GRI. These are the parameters as suggested. Sustainability projects, the haulage, linear, all the things I have told. On these basis, actually they assess and evaluate where you are in the sustainability framework. These are the awards and achievements NMDC has got. I was just mentioning about the Platts, S&P Platts Award. You can see our CMD here. Here our ex-director personnel is receiving. And other than that, many more other awards and accolades we have received recently within last 2-3 years. These are the things what we are going to have for our future. We are going to have a digital transformation through ERP implementation. We are going to implement this fleet management system and enterprise data hub implementation, all these through digital transformation, improvement projects that we do, skill development, culture building, and investments. You can see and other strategic and critical raw materials such as rare earth, battery minerals. Here, or we have got a we used to call it business development department. So that is looking after all these diversification and new areas where we can enter. And this HR expenditure, I have already said, I think R&D center, and then other steps which has been taken. During this extraordinary times also, NMDC as a responsible organization has not only made necessary arrangements for our employees, also NMDC has reached to the nearby villages and helped them in whatever safety, sanitary requirements were to be made, that NMDC has extended masks and all those things, sanitizers. So that is the our information. And these are some of the pictures of NMDC mines. You can see. So this is just them. Thank you, all of you, for the patient hearing. And I hope through this presentation, I have been able to address the theme that was given by AKS University to me. And I thank all the audience, I thank all the people. If there is any question, you can send to me. I will be happy to reply. Thank you.
Thank you, Sapal sir. Mr. Anand Soni is there. Soni sir, Anandji?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Anand Soni, our Pro Chancellor of AKS University.
I think I'm here, sir.
Make a formal welcome and to Mr. Sir. We have met him at Khajuraho seminar. You shared the dais with Mr. Satpathy also. Over to Mr. Anand Soni.
Satpathy sir, namaskar.
Namaskar, namaskar.
सर एनएमडीसी जिस हिसाब से पूरे हिंदुस्तान में अलग अलग जगह पे काम कर रहा है और एक सेक्टर आप संभाल रहे हैं तो ये मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि हमारे जो फ्यूचर के बच्चे हैं उनके लिए एक बहुत सेफ प्लेस क्रिएट हो रहा है जो आपके बाद में और आपके अंडर में नीचे नीचे धीरे धीरे काम करेंगे। हमारा विश्वविद्यालय की तरफ से ये प्रयास रहा है हमेशा कि हम उन लोगों के सामने बच्चों को रूबरू कराएं जिन्होंने की पूरी माइंस को देखा है, उसका इतना एक्सपीरियंस है और वो अपना एक्सपीरियंस उन लोगों के साथ शेयर कर सके, बच्चों के साथ। मैं जयंतु साहब का, साहू साहब का, पाल साहब का, सभी का बहुत स्वागत करता हूं और सबको धन्यवाद देता हूं सर कि आपने इस कोविड के दौरान भी और इतनी व्यस्तता, जहां पे पीछे में देख रहा हूं फाइलों का अंबार लगा हुआ आपके पास दिख रहा है और उसमें भी आप अपना समय दे रहे हैं। हमारे यहाँ तो सतना में लॉकडाउन है, शायद आपके क्षेत्र में भी लॉकडाउन है तो अच्छा अभी वहां नहीं है लेकिन यहाँ पर तो लॉकडाउन है सर। हमें प्रधान साहब को, हमारे मित्तल साहब और पूरी आईटी की टीम जो लॉकडाउन के दौरान वहां पर विश्वविद्यालय में उपस्थित है और वेबिनार कर रहे हैं, जयंतु साहब लगातार उसको सुन रहे हैं और आगे बढ़ा रहे हैं। मैं सर बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देता हूं आपका कि आपने मुझे समय, विश्वविद्यालय को समय दिया था। थैंक यू वेरी मच सर।
थैंक यू, थैंक यू,
थैंक यू। मैं क्विकली एक चीज बताना चाहता हूं। सत्यपति साहब, आपके और आपके टीम के सहयोग से पन्ना में वी वर इन्वॉल्व इन एनजीटी कंप्लायंस रिपोर्ट फॉर बटरफ्लाई। हम लोग ने, हमारा वी हैव गॉट वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग एग्रीकल्चर डिपार्टमेंट एंड हॉर्टिकल्चर डिपार्टमेंट। हम लोग एक बटरफ्लाई के लिए गार्डन बेड क्रिएट किया था, बटरफ्लाई आए थे, फोटो उठाए थे, वी मेड ए रिपोर्ट एंड इट वाज प्रेजेंटेड टू बिफोर द एनजीटी। ये अपॉर्चुनिटी आप लोगों ने दिया। उसके अलावा भी हम लोग स्लोप स्टेबिलिटी में भी कुछ काम पन्ना में किए थे। जब आप बेलाडिला में थे, वी ऑर्गेनाइज सम ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम ऑन ब्लास्टिंग एंड कुछ ब्लास्ट स्टडी किए थे, उसमें प्लास्टिक बॉटल वगैरह यूज किए थे। सो दैट प्लास्टिक का पीछे हम लोग पढ़े हैं कि उसको कैसे यूज किया जाए, दैट वी डिड। धोनी मलाई में भी ब्लास्टिंग स्टडी ऑन प्रोग्राम किए थे। होपफुली वी विल रिपीट इट आफ्टर द कोविड ब्रेक इज देयर। एंड सबसे मजे की बात है, आपका सस्टेनेबल प्रोजेक्ट में एक था केमिकल बाइंडर। मायसेल्फ और आपके कुछ कलीग्स एंड आनंद जी, हम लोग विजिट किए थे चाइना। चाइना में एक इंटरनेशनल एग्जीबिशन में वन कैनेडियन कंपनी है डेवलप्ड ए एंजाइम बेस्ड केमिकल विच एक्ट्स एज ए बाइंडर। वो बाइंडर का अनुकरण करके या हमारा उसी का आइडिया में उस कंपोजिशन से एंजाइम बेस्ड हम लोग, एंजाइम इज नथिंग बट वी आर ड्रॉइंग फ्रॉम द सुगर कैन इंडस्ट्री। सुगर मिल से हम लोग लेके हम लोग एक एंजाइम बेस्ड केमिकल यूज किए हैं। उसका इनिशियल ट्रायल ओवर हुआ है उत्कल एल्युमिना बॉक्साइट में एंड सम लाइमस्टोन माइन में। वो इट इज गिविंग वेरी गुड रिजल्ट। 120 टन डंपर भी उसका ऊपर चढ़ता है तो ब्रेक नहीं होता है। सो आफ्टर द कोविड इज ओवर आवर लैब विल बी फुल फ्लेज टू प्रोड्यूस बिकॉज इट इज अ वेरी इनिशियल। वी हैव फाइनलाइज द फॉर्मूला, डेवलप्ड इट, टेस्टेड इट। आयरन ओर में टेस्ट करने के लिए आपका सर आशीर्वाद चाहिए, आपका कोऑपरेशन चाहिए।
ऑपरेशन के लिए
जी, वो क्या है, आप एक लीटर पानी में फ्यू ml डाल देंगे, देन इट विल बिकम ए बाइंडर। ये इसका बारे में आई थिंक मिस्टर आनंद सोनी कैन गिव सम ब्रीफिंग। आनंद
सर, मैं थोड़ा सा इसको ब्रीफ कर देता हूँ सर। एक्चुअली सर, जो माइंस में आप लोगों को एक समस्या होती है कि धूल बहुत उड़ती है और दूसरा है रोड की स्टेबिलिटी नहीं रहती है। जब हमारा पानी गिरता है तो उसमें बड़ा दिक्कत खड़ी हो जाती है कि आपके बड़े बड़े लोडर्स जो है वो चलने में दिक्कत होती है। तो हमने जो एक केमिकल डेवलप किया है और वी आर गोइंग फॉर पेटेंट ऑल्सो कि आपका जो रोड है वह आप कंक्रीट रोड वहां बना नहीं सकते बरसात के टाइम में, और नॉर्मल टाइम में जब गर्मी होती है तो वह धूल इतनी उड़ती है कि आप उसको उसमें पानी स्प्रे करना पड़ता है। तो ये क्या है, ये एक ऐसा बाइंडर बन जाता है कि कंक्रीट के आसपास की स्ट्रेंथ दे देता है विद द लोकल मटेरियल, जो आपका वहां का मिट्टी है उसी मिट्टी में मिला करके उसको केमिकल को हम जब डाल देते हैं और उसपे से लोडर्स वगैरह सब चलना चालू हो जाते हैं तो हार्ड होना स्टार्ट हो जाता है और वह ऑलमोस्ट कंक्रीट की स्ट्रेंथ पे आ जाता है और इसमें पानी पेनिट्रेट नहीं करता। जो हमने बाहर देखा था केमिकल उसमें पानी पेनिट्रेट कर जाता था तो वो रोड खराब हो जाती थी, लेकिन जो हमने केमिकल डेवलप किया है उसमें पानी पेनिट्रेट नहीं करता। और जब गर्मी होगी तो आपके रोड से धूल नहीं उड़ेगी, आपको जो इस पानी स्प्रे करना पड़ता है वो नहीं करना पड़ेगा, तो जो पॉल्यूशन का प्रॉब्लम है वो खत्म होगा। और दूसरी चीज, जो हम गाड़ी लेकर के चलेंगे तो गाड़ी लेकर के चलने में हमारी रोड बची रहेगी, क्योंकि आपके साथ में रोड की स्टेबिलिटी बनाए रखना भी बहुत आवश्यक है, क्योंकि आप इतना माल ढोते हैं वहां से कि नॉर्मली वो और परमानेंट रोड बना नहीं सकते।
नहीं ठीक है, बोल रहे हैं
जी, तो ये आपके लिए एक मिरेकुलस प्रोडक्ट हो सकता है सर। बढ़िया,
आई रिमेम्बर
सर,
अर्लियर एक प्रोडक्ट आता था डस्ट्रम नाम से, वो केमिकल था बट उसमें कुछ डिमेरिट्स था, लाइक उसमें पटहोल्स पड़ जाते थे, फिर उसमें सम स्किन जो है इचिंग वगैरह लोगों को होता था जो हैंडल करते थे। तो दैट टाइम आई थिंक इट वाज सम 15-20 इयर्स बिफोर, सो लॉट ऑफ इंप्रूवमेंट मस्ट हैव टेकन प्लेस। रिसेंटली आल्सो इन आवर डोनीमलाई माइंस, I think Mr. S.K. Jain is there from Panna. He was in Donimalai just before going to Panna. So we had also conducted some trials, as you are saying, that it will be almost like concrete. And some people, we have got, I told you, we have got a coking coal mine in ICBL, Mozambique. There actually it was being operated by Rio Tinto. And the practice was going on, the whatever practice there. And there also they have made the road in such, those who have visited. Unfortunately, being a director there also, I have not been able to visit that place so far. But the road, they say, is almost near to the concrete type of thing.
Yeah.
And where, as you say, there will be no penetration or percolation of water, which will be responsible for damaging the road. And also the requirement of spraying, water spraying, it will be reduced from Delhi to Delhi. We are now spraying on an average 4 to 5 times on a road during the day, whereas it will be required to spray, I think, once in 10 days or 12 days like that, if I am correctly.
Yes, sir. Or actually, ye, sir, jo hamara hai, ye bilkul biological material pe bana hua hai. To isme fayda ye hai ki jab aap usko road jo hai, wo decompose hogi, to wo normal mitti jaisi rahegi, waisa aap usme ped bhi laga sakte hain.
Degradation hoga.
हाँ, बायोडिग्रेडेबल है, लेकिन वो ड्यूरेशन उसका बहुत लंबा है।
ठीक है, उसका वांस यू आर सेटिस्फाइड विद द ट्रायल्स एंड ऑल दैट, यू सेंड अस द डिटेल्स एंड वी विल हैव ट्रायल्स इन आवर माइंड्स।
थैंक यू सर,
थैंक यू वेरी मच सर, थैंक यू।
तो या उसके अलावा सर, अभी आई थिंक टुडे इज द लास्ट डे ऑफ ए वेरी डायनामिक सीएमडी ऑफ NMDC, Mr. Bajendra Kumar IAS. Please convey our best wishes to him post retirement. He must be, he looks young and his delivery capabilities are unparalleled in the industry. So convey our best wishes to him.
Yes, and also
welcome Mr. Deb, a colleague of yours from the board, taking over a CMD NMDC. Convey our best wishes to him also. Our Satpati Sahab, yeah, we must thank you. And we have made a request for putting into training to one of the first lady candidate of mining at Panna. And today I got a message that it is almost through. We are thankful to you, sir, for accommodating.
Sir, तो lady जो आ रहे हैं mining में, ऐसे mining में gents नहीं जाना चाहते हैं. Lady आ रहे हैं तो उनके लिए जो facility training का या जो भी करना है. Mr. Jain, I think he has taken care of.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you very much, sir. And last word from our editor-in-chief and Professor Jayantu, an expert in mining. Professor Jayantu, with your words, we will close the webinar of the day. Professor Jayantu, please.
Hey, mute mein hai, mute mein.
Sir, aap apna mic unmute kar lijiye. Jayantu, sir.
अपन नहीं कर सकते।
Yeah, sir. Okay.
Thank you very much, Satpati sir, for your. I am audible now.
Yeah.
So, for your highly informative paper, sir, it is not only just useful for our students, but also industrialists and others. And not only iron ore mining industry, but other industries also, whether it is extracting any mineral. So you have given an exhaustive review of your total activities as a director. Really, we felt very happy. Some of our students also.
फिर कट गया आपका म्यूट हो गया फिर म्यूट म्यूट अनम्यूट करिए फिर
नाउ इट इज ओके
नाउ इट इज
या सो दिस विल बी हाईली यूजफुल फॉर ऑल आवर नेक्स्ट जनरेशन सर एंड हियर आई हैव नोटेड सो मेनी पॉइंट्स बट आई विल नॉट टेल ऑल दोस पॉइंट्स वी आर ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ आवर इंडियन माइनिंग एंड इंजीनियरिंग जर्नल our special congratulations for achieving those international awards to NMDC under your leadership with dedicated efforts and there are so many issues you mentioned and it is highly useful but only small information for the benefit of the present generation and present industrialists so you may throw light after 1-2 minutes about what are the special provisions or measures taken for this COVID-19 that you can say, sir, after just 2 minutes. I will just brief about 2 minutes. Later, you can tell about that. So that may be more useful. And here, as a part of your up to 5-star rating from 1958, you have given a wonderful total journey. And it is really a very innovative, I should say, disruptive translational technologies are being implemented so that has made your company with a very good R&D facilities since I have been associated closely with our Chaurasia and G.V. Rao all this group and you are not mentioned but we are highly thankful for inviting us also in that MPT we have conducted so many events that means even educating the next generation your NMDC is not behind you are always ahead and really we are very proud of our national mineral development corporation sir with this I just would like to add recently your R&D department is also doing some more very good work on waste management this blast slag this fly ash for fertilizer and other things I felt very happy in all these issues and working with JNTU and nearby Usmania IMMT and you are doing the wonderful work as far as our education industry research all these activities are concerned truly an international scenario in the best possible as a role model we appreciate once again sir now you can just highlight in this period COVID-19 period so what will be your suggestion and what steps you have taken so that it will be a role model for others
yeah thank you professor Jayantu In fact, I have not covered all the things what you have intentionally or unintentionally. A lot of things have also been left out. For example, the power regeneration through our downhill conveyor that I have not mentioned. That is also a sustainable initiative which was taken long back. Surprisingly, this step was taken long back in the 70s and 80s, so that we can regenerate some of the power because of the movement of the downward movement of the conveyor carrying load. So that is one thing, and so many other things like you have said about this R&D efforts. So a lot of things have been done in R&D efforts, but I did not cover all those areas. And recently also through R&D, we are also have an tie-up with IIT Hyderabad. For this startup India.
Yes.
So we are having a budget of initially a budget of 10 crores, which we can increase if we get incubation center also. So all the things I have not covered. These are all sustainable. Whatever you do for the society, for the youngsters, for the students, Even I would have loved to come to AKS University to have direct one-to-one interaction. I must say that when the people are taking training, undergoing training from institutes like NIT, IIT or ISM for that matter, as a MICE manager, I used to ask them questions after the training is over, whether they have learned the basic things or not. But to my surprise, I must share with you, there is lot of gap. People do not take training seriously. I tell you, for 1 month you are there, but at least go 10 days to the field and learn something. That will help you in your future career. So I think in that area, the educational institutes like AKS University and you being the in NIT Rourkela, you'll look all those things into all those things, improve the standard of the student who is coming out from the institute. He should be having a lot of knowledge, because afterwards you do not get a lot of scope for learning. Some companies, they have done away with this graduate training year, 1 year training also. People are not nowadays following. Right from day one, they are given assigned job and they are learning through the work experience. So you are asked me in particular about the COVID arrangements, what our company has done. I must tell you that fortunately, doing the projects in the remote area and also area where full of oxygen is there, lot of oxygen is there available in those areas where lot of greenery is there, forest cover is there, like in Baralela. So there actually we did not have much cases. Only with the CISF, some cases are there in Bachali, reported there in Bachali. And recently in Dhunimalai project, some cases have been surfaced up. But what arrangements we have made as a team, because now Dr. Pradhan was talking about the leadership quality of Mr. Vajendra Kumar, you will be surprised to know that in February, the BDAC program there, which is conducted in Toronto, Canada, for that 7 or 8 participants nominated, sponsored by NMDC to attend. And at that time, there was no news of this pandemic in India. But people came back on 8th or 9th, but all of them, on the instruction of our CMD, were quarantined for 14 days. So that is the advanced sort of preventive measures which was taken by all the 7-8 people, those who went from projects also, they were asked to be under quarantine. Those who went from head office, they were quarantined. And in our office, what we are following, we have got all this the thermal scanning and this sanitizing system at the entry point. The security guards will not allow you unless and until you are thermally scanned, until and unless you are sanitized your hands. And also the office is sanitized every week as a routine. And from Friday second half, we are asked to vacate. And from Friday, because it has to be for, I think, 48 hours. So till Monday morning, the sanitization effect should be there. So that the whatever virus or germs are there, they kill. So 48 hours are allowed for the people who are in there for carrying out the sanitation work. And those measures are taken. And in all the projects, although mining is such an industry where you do not, except the blasting or some other activities, you do not require the people to gather. But where we from the beginning, we made the plan in such a way that the canteen timing staggering was done. In transportation also staggering was done. We introduced shift timing, like 4 hours, 3 hours, like that people were given. There was a relaxation in the actual timing of the shift so that people can maintain the social distancing and norms and they can go without having any risk exposures. And the equipment also, initial 1 hour, 1.5 hours was sanitization. Then only the operators were allowed. So like that, they took a lot of measures in the projects. And our CSR also, that of this mask worth, I think, maybe 20, 25 lakhs rupees, masks and sanitizers were distributed and around the project areas. And the project has also come up with the innovative method of converting their this water spraying equipment into sanitizing equipment, which are used in the even the district areas. I think Donimalai, they had done it. The road sanitization, to that extent, NMDC has extended it. So these are some of the things. And in spite of that, I'm sorry to say that in Hyderabad, of late, actually, the situation is not good. And a lot of our officers, employees, they were tested positive. But so far, nothing has gone from bad to worse. Everything is under control. People are again tested negative and returning to work. I think this is the normal today. So we have to live with the virus and we have to take all the precautions and all the arrangements we have to make. That is way ahead. And it is not going to be eliminated or to be banished in next 1 month or 2 months. What people project will be there. But once the regulation comes and things will be, some solution will be there. But till then, we have to use the mask, we have to use the hand gloves, we have to wash our hands, we have to, all those things we have to do. So, just in what I could say, I think I have made myself.
Thank you, Sapre Sahab, Professor Jayantu, Mr. Jayan, Mr. Prajapati, all the team of team Sapre Sahab. Convey our best wishes to Mr. Pradendra Kumar and Mr. Deb. With these words, once again, Satish, how you spared some of your valuable time.
I think you register that is postponed to 10th, so I could.
Okay,
give
sir.
Thank you. Sir. I am seeing Mr. Vatwadekar is there and Mr. Paul is there, who are my old friends. So I am happy to see them in the virtual medium. Although it seems that we are talking face to face. Thank you for the opportunity, President, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Ganesh, sir, thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Okay. Thank you. Okay. फिर मुलाकात होती है सब.
Ganesh, sir, namaste. Okay, sir. सभी को धन्यवाद, sir. Thank you.